We are all conquerors in Jesus Christ. In today's gospel, my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus explains the parable regarding the weed that grew up along with the wheat. The wheat was sown by the farmer, whereas the weed was sown by the enemy of the farmer. This passage is explained in today's gospel. I picked up one aspect for our lives. When it was reported to the farmer regarding the weeds among the wheat, whether they could be plucked out, the farmer said, "No, let us wait till the harvest. And at the time of harvest, let's separate wheat from the weeds." Here, the farmer is God Himself. When we apply this passage for us, yes, we have negativity in us, a lot of negativity. And this negativity cannot take us on the road to righteousness. In order to be the children of God, we need to weed it out, all our negativities, all our sinfulness, all our negative behaviors. So, what is the approach of the farmer or God when it comes to our life? God knows that we do have shortcomings in us, we do have sinfulness in us. And just the way the farmer told his servants to wait till the harvest, the similar sense, God waits for our conversion. God waits for us to change. God waits for us to overcome our weaknesses, negativity, and become good. So here I see the character of God. The character of God is that of patience. He has patience with us, just the way the farmer had a great patience with the weed till the harvest time. Similar way, God is having patience with us. God is giving us time. God is giving us opportunities and facilities to fight against the negativities, the shortcomings, the sinfulness of our life. Not only God waits for us, or He is patient with us, or He gives us all facilities and opportunities, He also gives His graces to us to fight, to overcome. In the letter to the Romans, chapter 8, 31 onwards, He says that we are all conquerors in Jesus Christ, because Jesus is victorious, and therefore we have the share in the victory of Jesus, and we too can overcome our own shortcomings, weaknesses, our own negativity and sinfulness, for which God does give us His graces. It is now our responsibility. God has given us more and more opportunities, facilities and graces to overcome, to fight against our negativities. Let us not take for granted the opportunities God gave us, the facilities and graces God gave us. We need to think today in our own lives, how many opportunities God has given us to change our lives, to repent and to become a better person. If we have missed, we are again at fault. So how much can I test the patience of God? How long I can keep on taking God's graces and opportunities that He has given us for granted? Yes, He is merciful, He is loving, He is patient and kind. We need to accept these opportunities God gives us and fight with the graces of Jesus, overcome our sinfulness and live the life of the children of God. Let us not lose the opportunities.